of you, all the participants in Google Meet and the viewers on Facebook. We have with us today a very good resource person, Dr. Deepti Maheshwari, and it's my privilege to introduce her to all of you who are going to attend this webinar, 1 hour session on writing a research paper. A man presently serving in the capacity of Dean Commerce and Research Coordinator in Rabindranath Tagore University, Bhopal. In all, she is carrying 15 years of teaching experience with 7 years of research experience. Her specialization lies in accountancy, entrepreneurship, and research. More than 55 research papers are into credit, both international and national levels. 12 MPhil and 9 PhD degrees are awarded under her guidance. Ma'am is a chief editor of a national journal, Shodhayatan, and also an editorial number of national and international journals. Apart from academic, she is also serving as a behavioral trainer at government offices like CRISP. She has also coordinated international and national seminars and has got keen interest in social activities. She's a member of BMA, Bhopal Management Association, and had received Innovative Trainers Award by ISTD Bhopal's chapter in the year 2019. Ma'am, it's a privilege and we welcome you on behalf of Faculty of Management Studies and Parul University. It's so nice to have you with us, and we would like you to share all the information which an MBA student should know about writing a research paper. As a discussion, these students are SEM 2 students, and they are going into SEM 3, wherein they will be required to write a research paper. It's a compulsory now. So I think your session definitely will help our students to little bit know about how to go ahead with writing a research paper. Amita ma'am, would you like to say something to our guest?
Just one input. Deepti ma'am, just one input from my end. As rightly said by Sapta ma'am, these students are going to semester 3, and since it is mandatory for them to write a research paper in the second year of their MBA, so they must be having a lot of queries, and if you can take it from the scratch so that they will be able to understand how they can write a research paper, and that will be going to be beneficial to them. That is the only input I have for you.
Thank you, Amita ma'am. And Deepti ma'am, I hand over the session to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sapna ma'am. First of all, I am thankful to Parul University for this wonderful initiative, writing a research paper. Now, this is the need of our hour. Because of lots of problems are there in our society and everywhere. So first of all, I congratulate to your entire team. And I am thankful to Dr. Vijal ma'am, Dean Management of Studies. And I am also thankful Dr. Sapna Chauhan ma'am, Professor Amita Garg ma'am, for inviting me for this wonderful session. And today I'll try my best on my end. And definitely it is very useful to all your research scholars and you are a student basically for MBA third semester or first semester student. Now it is mandatory to write a research paper as per the NEC accreditation and as per the new guidelines of UGC. Before starting my presentation, first of all, I start with the quote, research is to see what everybody else has seen. Research is to see what everybody else has seen and to think what nobody else has thought, quoted by Albert. It's a very nice quote, which is given by the Albert. So today I'll start my presentation with this quote, writing research paper. Let's know. Today we will just go through what are the guidelines. Basically in a 1 hour, it can't be possible ki we will write all the research paper. Actually, there is a separate very other things also in the research paper. So today we will just go ki what is the outline or what are the main things are required for writing any research paper. So with this, today I'll try. Now in this lecture, these are the outlines. First of all, getting a start. Where, how, when, we will start. This is the very big question for all research scholars and freshers and other students. And regarding the your dissertation, yeah, your thesis work. First of all, research thought process, and the other one, the skills which are needed for writing the research paper. And go after that, we will discuss where how we will going ahead, identifying the area of research interest, reading and reviewing research literature. Actually, literature review is the most important part of any type of research paper. Without the reviewing, without the reading a proper way in the research paper or literature review, we can't find the any problem regarding the research paper. Next, identifying gaps in existing research. So after that review, we will go for the identify the gap in existing research. And next is choosing our topic. And after that, what is the roadmap here? What is the methodology for this topic? We will do in our research paper. And after that, our research progression will be go on identifying sampling, selection, data collection, data alignment. After that, analyzing the data. It's a very important part. Actually, when we will analyze the data, so what we will find in the data and how we will present in the data, it is the very big problem to all research scholars. And after that, what are the main things which is required to writing the research paper, grammar, referencing, and plagiarism. So just now getting a start. First, what is the research? First of all, think if we got any news in the newspaper, yeah, we see and we have seen any article on the Google and anywhere. So then we will our mind automatically thinking on that. After that, thinking on particular of one topic. And if you come every and if anything comes in your mind, after that, it is required for the brainstorming. So just you will discuss, you are discussing with your faculty members in your peer group. And after that, identify ki which type of problems in our surrounding. Just like observe the information, yeah, getting the other information from the world and all over the world. And after that, taking the some points on that and think on that. And after that, discuss with your entire group, yeah, other group persons, yeah, your seniors and your faculty members. Then identify. Now it's my problem. No, this type of problem we are facing. So we are, why can I not to work on that particular topic? After that, design the roadmap. And analyzing in the different method from the data analyzing methods and find out the some solutions. After the analyzing, it is very required ki we have to find out the some solution on that and comprehend it and after that conclude. Now research is, basically research is the two words, re plus search. Already searched some documents and everything, we will again think on that, we will again search on that, or we will do something new on that. This is the question once again will come in our mind. Then research is a systematic, logical, empirical, and reductive, replicable process. Systematic, actually, there is a system. First, we will identify the problem. And after that, we will go through the different type of literature review on particular topic and identify the what are the objectives which is required to solve these problems and what is the roadmap and analyzing the data. And we will find out some result on that. So that is the systematic process. It's a logical. Basically, logical are two types, inductive and deductive. Inductive logic, I observe something. And observe after that, after the observing the pattern, we will develop some theory on that. And deductive research start with existing theory. It is already have done work on that particular topic. After that, we will try to search out something, the existing theory, and formulate a hypothesis on that. And based on that hypothesis, we try to testing on over that, and after that we will analyze the data and go the particular result. That is called deductive. Mostly commerce and management student most probably going the deductive research. Now the empirical, actually research is based on the evidence, just like a the particular person, and research papers we can take as a evidence. And if we will go for the primary data, so we just fill up the questionnaire and everything. Actually, research, totally any type of research, is based on the evidence. And reductive, we can generalize, we can easy way, we can find out some easy way to generalize these statements. And after that, replicable, how we can show to public or generalize the statement, what is the method we will apply on that. So that is the main part of methodology. So research is a systematic, logical way. We will find out some solution on that. Now, the first point, thought process. Okay, so why do you want to undertaking the study? Why I am taking this study? Why we will go for this study? So first point in comes always come in our mind. Why? Actually, why concept comes in our mind when we have any question regarding the research, regarding the information. If we have a question, so definitely first point, is it clear at the time of your thought process? Second one, what personal reward you will get from doing it? Actually, for the MBA student, it is required because it is our part of the syllabus, so you have to do. And other, it's area, your area of interest, it may be possible. And some other way, it's a part of your dissertation. So what personal reward? And it's your inner satisfaction. That is totally depend upon you. First, we will think, why do you want this study? And after that, what is your personal reward? And after that, what this study will contribute? Whenever we try, we are searching somewhere, so we will try to do some solution of the particular problem. So it's a, it will be give any contribution to our society or any other way. So these three points comes in our mind when we talking about the research paper, your research, yeah, anything else. So the first three points comes in our mind, why we do, and the second, what is my personal interest, and third one, so it is a last, and it's a bright, it's a very wide goal, and what this study will contribute. So research thought process may, will I have anything new to say? I have some words regarding to say something new. And who will take the interest in my research? This is the one another question in our mind. And how do I go about it? Kaise? And asked, after the collect all the information, we will write something on that. So that is whole process of research. First, mere paas kuch kehne ke liye hai. I have something to say new to anybody. And the interest, kaun lega usme interest, kaun sunega usko? And the next one, how do I go about it? Kaise jaun? And last, writing up when we collect the information. Now, these are the funneling down some your thoughts. First of all, choosing a topic. So first we will discuss on that, how we will choose the topic. And after that, for choosing the topic, first of all, if you got any information regarding your interest of area anywhere in the newspaper, magazine, any website or any other way, so just to maintain a one diary with you. It is a very simple method. You just maintain a diary. Yeah, you just maintain a laptop. Now the smartphone, we can also use. So you just keep the most important point, yeah, highlight that points which you jo aapko sabse zyada appeal kar rahe hain, which you like the most. These are the important point which is related with my study. And after that, discuss with your peer group. Peer group, just like your friends, yeah, your seniors, your relatives, yeah, your other social media, you can discuss. And after discussing, you will definitely find something other information with your friends, yeah, with your near dears. And after that, discuss with your supervisor. Yeah, you're expert. Actually, the main focus is the who is our dissertation maintain and everything. So in every college, it is already allotted the some student with the mentors. So just I'll mention finding supervisor. So you just discuss with your supervisor, yeah, your experts, and after that they will definitely give you a new way for focusing on your topic. So then you will start the work on that. And finally, definitely you will get the topic. Okay, now this is my topic, or I'll go for the research work for the work in this topic. Now, first of all, awareness about the topic. So first of all, we will try to just wait. Sorry. First, we will try to awareness. First of all, we will gather the other information from the different places. Hello. Shall I continue, sir? Now the first point is awareness. For the awareness, it is very important. First of all, gather the information. Yeah, we have to very good sufficient knowledge about the topic. And after that, what is the interest? Interest, basically, if there is any information which is related with your topic, and take the decision, okay, this is my topic. Actually, researchers more or less are very confused when we talk about the write a research paper. So first of all, awareness about your topic, and after that, if it is interesting for your way, so then you can take decision, and after that comes in the action. Now, what are the research skills which is required? What are the other things which is required for writing a research paper? First number is reading. Read from wide variety of sources. Wide variety, just like print journals, online journals, articles, newspaper, magazines, websites. To read from wide variety of sources, and so you will get the deep insight about your topic. After that, reading all the materials and get the sufficient. You will get the sufficient information. Then, deep insight for with your colleges, with your friends, and with your teachers, and with your experts. Then you will find some other information from that particular persons, yeah, that your friends, yeah, your teachers. And after that, like reading and listening, it involves categorize, improve your observations. Just when we will gather the other information from all over the world, then we will our senses are active that time, our ears and eyes, and then our mind is starting the some process on that. And after that, we will write some. We will come to the right and write something. So related, watching the other things like reading and listening, there is another important research skill is a watching. Improve your observation and comprehensive of visual signals. It's actually normally we will see okay, if we are watching something, so then definitely we will get some information, and it will have us. Yes. Hello. Now the second is research skill is to then other ones choosing. From a variety of options, we have plenty of options with us. Then it is helpful to choose the options and helps in sampling and selections. And after that, questioning, direct question and through review in information. At whenever we gathered a sufficient information, then we have a lots of question in our mind. Then you start the questioning with your experts within in your peer group and develop skills of using documentary sources. And when you will get the any reply, whenever you get the reply of your questions, so you will note it these questions also. After that, try to summarize in the meaningful way and try to, it is very helpful to managing your data, which you have already collected. These are the research skills. First number, reading, listening, watching, and other, choosing, questioning, and summarizing. Now, after gather the all information, we will going ahead for our research work. So now these are the first process is the in the identify of the research problem. If we will find, we have already find out our area and we gather the information. So then we will search regarding the research papers, yeah, regarding the articles. So there are 10 reasons why you reach. It will give you ideas. A lots of ideas comes in your mind when you reading the some material which is already on the websites, on newspaper or magazines. And you need to understand what other researchers have done in your areas. Matlab, what is the new in your area? Yeah, other researchers, what they are do they have done their research. And to broaden your perspective and set your work in contest in this way, and direct personal experience can never be enough. Actually, when we will questioning to somewhere, yeah, we will discuss, yeah, we are discussing our topic with the faculty members here within my in peer group. So definitely you will get the sufficient information. If you take your idea on your own, though it is not enough. First of all, we will we have to discuss with your groups also to legitimate your arguments. It may cause you to change your mind. Writers need to read, matlab, for the writing something you have to need to read, matlab, you have to select the data so that you can efficiently categorize that over have done, to learn more about research method and their methods, which type of method they have used and what they have analyzed and what is the conclusion in the research paper. So that it is more helpful to all of you when we read some material, when we review the some material, in order to support areas which have not been researched. So it is very useful if the study have done in a Gujarat, so you can do the you can find out the other, in any other area you can find out any other state. There are same problem because some problems are naturally in other states also. So we can do, if one person study our A tier group of the cities or B tier of the cities, so you can take other way. So it is a very good approach when we reading the literature review, yeah, reading research literature. Based on the reading, where to read? First of all, using library, using internet. When just like I have done my research on tax evasion, so when I have done my at the time of I am in MCOM, I was in MCOM, so just I thought this topic I just listened tax evasion word. So then what is the tax evasion, and this is the just question in my mind. And after that I'll search, I was searching somewhere just like research papers in library and internet. So this type things you can do using library, using internet. And what to read, just like books, if there is any books related, just like a neuromarketing, it's a new concept, and the mind mapping. So these are the just like in account side, to cloud computing, forensic accounting, and in entrepreneurship side, so there are multiple works done in our scenario. So what is the new in that? So just to read the books, journals, reports, and use the popular media, computer based material also. And whom to read, just like just browse, and after that you can start the read all these things. Then what are the questions and literature review must answer you get? What are the key sources, first of all? And what are the key theories, concept, and ideas on behind the on the right door? Well, just jo aapne paper mein likha hai, wo kis tarike ka hai? And what are the research ya analyze, how they have analyzed the research and everything? And what are the main questions and problems that have been addressed in a particular research paper? how is knowledge on the topic structure and organized, and what are the organization definition about the topic, and what are the supporting documents, what are the sources. So these are information you will get, and you will find out the some gap in the research paper. Definitely you will find out. Or there is another way. You can use the tabulation form also for the literature review. In the tabulation form, in a first column, the author name, and second column year, and third column for the topic, and fourth column the objective. If there is any objective, it is definitely every research paper have their own objective. So just you find out the objective in the research paper, and after that what is the methodology is used in the research paper. So you just pin down the methodologies of the research paper, and after that you have to also conclude the research paper in a last pair of the conclusion, and pin down the conclusion also. And after that, you will collect all the material in the tabulation form, so you definitely find out the gap. Actually, first of all, we have to identify gap in the literature survey and in the other review. Actually, they are मतलब वो बहुत ज़्यादा आपके टॉपिक की तरफ आपको लेकर जाएगा, और आप you will be focusing particularly on your topic. Then map out the literature, key track of what the authors told you, and the questions that occurs to you whenever you read and find the solution. Use mind maps, tables, charts, pictures. This is the one another way to find out the problem. Research each of your question to see if there are people out there out had the same questions and found answer to them. So in which way they will go, they have to, matlab they have already gone through in the research. If you don't find any answer to one of your questions, you have probably found a research gap from which you can develop your research. Okay, if you want to develop some new theory, if you give the some other observation in the existing theory, so this is the another way. First, you will not only you will find your answers, but also you will find you can develop some new ways, new dimensions in particular research. Now, choosing the topic points, you might bear in mind mean making a choice available. Motivate yourself for the motivation it is required. Okay, it is your interest or area. Regulations and expectation regarding your research work, subject or file, maybe of the your study, size of topic, size. Actually, nowadays it's we are more emphasizing on the qualitative research. So I think size is very narrow down, and topic of size is also very narrow down, and availability of time. Actually, time management is required when we write the any research paper. Otherwise, we can't write. We can't write any single word if we will not give the a timeline. Okay, in which time we will be, and after that we will do this work, and after that we will do this work. And cost for the research paper, and what are the research resources available in our periphery. So, and assess issues. Can I assess some issues on our using the choosing the topic? Now, the choosing methodology. In choosing a research topic, it makes sense to think about the method you will use to collect and analyze data as soon as possible. Actually, I have already mentioned in the time management for choosing topic. So you have to analyze the data. So you have to clear the research methodology. The methods you use are a key part of your research paper. So you need to understand something of the alternatives available to you. What is your what is the strength in the research paper, or what are the weakness is just like a research gap. Then there are types of research. So there are mainly two types of research, quantitative or qualitative. I have already said ki nowadays we are more emphasizing on the qualitative research. Now quantitative, it's just like in numbers. If I want to identify anything in numbers, just like average height of the of the class student, yeah, average number of the class student, this type of, when we will find out the some work on the numbers, so we will go for the quantitative research. And qualitative research, I want to go in depth in a particular topic, just like it is actually defined in the words, content analysis, word analysis, letters analysis, and depth in a particular firm, particular company, and particular family. If this type of research, if we want to do, we will go to our qualitative research. Now, desktop or field work. Naturally, it depends upon your topic. If it is only on based on secondary data, so you can use only text work. You can just go through access that particular government sites, other resources. Then after that, you can analyze this work, and you can find some solution, other solutions also. And in field work, so you have to collect the primary data, then we will coding that data, and after that we will identify some we will analyzing work, and after that we will find out some result on that. Now this is the research approaches. First, we will first of all, when we decide the topic, so we have already decided ki it's our action research. I just go for the case study. It's a experimental research. It is on survey base. So when we will identify, we have already choose the topic. So this is already identified in the topic. If it is a action research, so you have to go somewhere and apply that particular thing, and after that we will see. We will observe the action on that. Then if we will write a case study, so in the qualitative research, more or less we are using this word case study, and a particular firm, particular person, particular family, particular product, we will use the case study method. Experiment, it is useful more or less for the medical students, science students, when they are experiment some work on that. And survey, if you need, just like a government is already proposed any type of policy or any type of yojana, just like a Jandhan yojana, so when we will discuss with the rural area for surveying ki they are using this they are using or not Jandhan yojana, which is already proposed by the government, so we will use the survey method. Now the research technique, actually these are any type of approach when you have discussed, you have to discuss in your research design also. Then research techniques, which type of technique we are using to data collection. So just like a documentary, yani ki only published data or record of data, interview method or observation method or by a questionnaire. So in which method we will use in our research study or in our research paper. So then which method to use. So first research question, what exactly are you trying to find out? So we have already discussed in the topic. So I think this question every time comes in our mind and regularly comes in my mind. Ki what are I am trying to find out something. And after that, other researchers' results, it is relevant with my topic in which way? This is even another question. And practical consideration, just like a issue of time, money, and the sample which I have used actually for the all over the country, all over the population, if we will take, so it can't be possible we do any type of research work. So sampling, availability of samples, and in which method we have collect the data. After that, knowledge payoff, which approach will be more useful, just like action research or case study, in which type of method I'll use for more information, for gathering the more information. And then style, what paradigm and philosophical issues are involved in this research, or how a good piece of research look like, in which way. So this is the style. This is now the picture of research progression. So first we will identify, first we will discuss, so we have already discussed our topic and surveying some literature review, find out the gap, and after that research approach and technique. So this is the progression. Now, what is the sampling we will choose in our research? Probability sampling, there are two mainly sampling, probability or non-probability sampling. For probability sampling, simple random sampling, I just take a sample just a Gujarat in a particular, in our university. For youngster, they are just like a online or offline research. If I want to see just the behavioring approach or behavioring style to that particular persons which online or offline shopping, वो क्या देख रहे हैं, क्या वो महसूस कर रहे हैं online और offline में, just observing this thing. So we can take go through the simple random sampling. Just we have decided our sample just 500 and just go through simply कि I don't know कि उन लोगों को इस चीज की knowledge है या नहीं. But simply I collect the randomly select the data, and after that systematic sampling. Systematic sampling, actually we have already knowledge about the particular sample कि इनको मेरी चीज के बारे में knowledge है और नहीं है, ये चीज मैं पहले से ही अपने दिमाग में रखती हूँ, and then we will go for the systematic sampling. Stratified sampling, sampling within a group of the population. Within a group, you are also the part of that particular group. That is called stratified sampling. And after that, clustering. Clustering, yani ki surveying whole cluster of the population sampled at random. Just I choose the groups, small groups randomly. That is called cluster. And we will discuss. We will discuss the topic. Regarding my research work, and after that we will definitely get some solution of some observation, yes, some point from the particular group. Now the convenience sampling. Nowadays maximum youth are using this sampling, convenience. Actually what is my convenience, just like my friends, my colleagues, jo mere question ka definitely reply de payenge. So I'll always thought in particular convenience sampling. Sampling choose most convenient, जिसके ऊपर मुझे trust है कि they will definitely give me a reply on my questionnaire, on my at the time of interview या at the time of survey. So it's a convenient sampling maximum time we are using. And now the quota sampling, convenience sampling within the group of the population. Quota sampling is just like we have selected these some people from the convenience sampling, and we will develop us some small group of the population, and after that we are observing, yeah, we will give our questionnaire to fill a particular quota or particular group, then we will find some answers from the particular questions. Now the non-probability sampling, these are the probability sampling, maybe it may be possible or it may be not be possible. Then other one, non-probability sampling, judgment, yeah, purposive sampling, handpicking supposedly typical and interesting cases. Just when I identify already my research topic, so we will find out some cases on interesting cases on particular group, and we will work on that. And snowball, building sample through informants. Okay, so just a long big group, we will identify. I discuss with my one friend, yeah, in a small group. After that, they are discussing the other persons, and after that, they are discussing with some other persons. Then it's a very big group. We will find out, and after that, we will get some solution from the different groups of a particular problem. Now these are the data collection methods. There are two data collection method, primary data collection and secondary data collection. Primary data collection basically based on the first time we will find out some data regarding the our topic, just through the interview method, telephonic method, yeah, survey method, yeah, observation method or experimental method. And other the main source is the secondary data. तो सेकेंडरी डेटा फॉर फ्रॉम द पब्लिश्ड रिसर्च आर्टिकल वी कैन फाइंड एंड सम जस्ट लाइक अ पब्लिश्ड रिपोर्ट्स एंड रिकॉर्ड्स एंड रिसर्च आर्टिकल्स मैगजीन्स. तो दीज आर दी सेकेंडरी डेटा which I've already, when we will, we have, when we are discussing about topic, so then we have already identified the time of literature review. And when we talk about the data source, so if you your paper is related with, more related with the primary data, so you just find out in which technique we will use to collect the data. Just a questionnaire, yeah, interview, yeah, survey, yeah, panel discussion, in which method? So just first is the interview method. So we have already find out some questions, structured questions, and after that we are trying to we will go to the respondent and collect the data regarding the information. It is door to door, or it may be possible through the mail. Nowadays it is very convenient through the mail to collect the data. And after that, if survey, so you have already seen कि बहुत सारे surveys हमारे mails पर आते हैं. We will give the reply on that. Then observing on the collection of the survey, then we will identify some solution of the particular problem. And next, just like panel discussion, there are if there is any topic which is related your which is related your research work, so you can discuss in the panel, and already you have structured some questions on that, and after that you will discuss with the panel members jo already expert in particular areas mein, so unse you can discuss. And another one method is the questionnaire. It is a more useful method, and it is widely used everywhere. Just like you have framed some variables from your topic, and after that you will generate some questions on that. At the time of making the preparing the questionnaire, first of all you will take the just general information, and after that related with your variables. It is the need, because one by one on your variables you can frame the some questions. And after the, in the Google form you can collect. It's a very simple method for UG or PG students. So you can collect the data in the Google form. After that, the analyzing, it is more easy to analyze to all of you. Now these are the some key aspect of data collection. Keeping the note every time in at the time of progress. Research diary we have already discussed. And you have discussed with the will go the interview method. So you just keep the diary with you, and whenever you can use the, your mobile also for recording the answers for particular research. Just like an idea way to of keeping a record of what you are doing, feeling, thinking throughout the research. Boxes or files, keep all the material in the particular files and boxes. Yeah. Your laptop, yeah, your tab, your desktop, colored papers, and sticky notes. Huh? When we have collected all these information, na, so we, it is very helpful when we highlighted the points in the research paper, which is more related our topic or our research work. Now the computers, you may input your thoughts, records, reference direct on to your input, on your computer, or your tab, yeah, your laptop. Now chasing up, meticulous is chasing up of your progress and responses expected from others, at the same time being realistic, flexible about the expectation of collecting data. Now when to stop collecting data, keep to the schedule as much as possible. As it's a time, you give the timeline yourself, just like a 1 month, 2 month. So you have to collect all the data in particular timeline. Collect only whenever you collect the sufficient data regarding your research paper. For the one research paper, 50 to 60 sample or 100 sample we can use. So I think this is the sufficient time for the collect data. Just like a 1 month, and move on to analyzing data as soon as possible. Whenever you collect the data. Now. another third step is organizing data. First of all, managing your data by reducing its size and scope. You have collected lots of information. It is not necessary ki all information is useful. All informations are useful for regarding your topic. So you can do one thing, you can squeeze the data, size squeeze, reducing your size that you collected, otherwise you have confused. Now the coding, the process by which item or groups of data are assigned codes, just like when we collecting the data, we are using the SPSS. So at the time of using the SPSS, we have convert all our data into the numbers. So just we will just like are you male or female? So for male we have given the one number, for female for two. This type of coding it is required because of quantity. When we talk about the quantifying the numbers, so then we have to coding the data. If the Likert scale we are using, so one for agree, fit, strongly agree, neutral, not agree. Strongly not agree. This type of coding in the numbers it is required. Annotating, the process by which written or audio visuals material is altered by the addition of notes or comments. So it is also very necessary, the progress of you written the something material and adding something in their research work. Now the techniques. First technique is labeling. These labels can then serve to direct further analysis. Okay, so we are labeling it comes in the SPSS when we talk about in the next time, when definitely what is the SPSS, then we will discuss about the labeling, selection and summarizing. Then in a simple way, so you can use the Google form, and Google form mein it is already comes at the time of labeling, when jab aapne one for male, two for female, so it is a labeling. And then label your question, just like which type of things you are like most. This type of questions also come in the labeling, so you can draw the graphs on that, just a pie chart and other things. So it is very easy to see, to clear, to understood to everyone ke ye kya cheez hai, kis tarike se identify isme ho rahi hai. Now the selection, a key process in the management of data through which interesting, significant, usual or representative items are chosen to illustrate the arguments. Okay, so key process it is very required in the managing the data. And now a summary, the process to retain, reduce version, precise, or just like a, you can maintain synopsis on your research work, just like a, what is your topic or what is your objective, and RM which will be used to your research paper. So they summarize these points, then it is very easy to write the research paper. Now after regressing, analyze is mean to regress process using data that has been carefully produced or managed. In the end, however, what is produced from it is the original document, which attempt to pursue readers of research interpretation. So when you have analyzed the data, so what test will be apply the data which you have already collected through the any method you have used, you have already used. So what we will identify, this is the biggest question when we analyzing the data. So at the time of research design, in the synopsis you can also write down the method. We are write down the test also. It's a descriptive statistics or it's a inferential statistics. So there are two levels of quantitative data analysis: descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. For the descriptive statistics, we just explain the theory, just there is a association or not, or the frequency, average and range. For identify these things, we just go through descriptive statistics, there is a relationship or not. In the inferential statistics, we are going the in depth, just like a chi-square for the impact, anything impact, just like a coronavirus jis tarah se chal raha hai ya iska impact kya pad raha hai on society. So this is the depth. So we can use the inferential statistics, and correlation, regression, and regression, just like abhi last 10 years ki sale hi hai and next 5 years what we will be sale. This type of forecasting we are using inferential statistics data. So more or less for the MCOM student, I think descriptive statistics it's a sufficient. If you want to go impact yeah comparing something, just like ek community ke people ka comparison with the other community people, so then we can use the descriptive statistics in that. Inferential for the T, basis on T. Now simple interrelationship cross tabulation yani ki t or multivariate analysis, so studying the only if we will take only one group to it's a univariate, we will take the two group to dual variate ho jata hai, after that more than two variables if we will take I have already discussed about the variable. If you are going for the quantitative data, so you just go through the variables, which type of variables are completing my research, will be completing my research work, so you will identify the just research work. Just like agar koi banda jata hai in hotels, so what they like most, so just hotel ka ambience, uski services, best prices, quality, so these are the variables. So for the for justifying our variable, which test is useful. If variables are one or two or more than two, so then we can use multivariable analysis. Computer based data analysis software, I have already discussed about the SPSS. It is the statistical package for the social science research, and commonly quantitative data analysis package Minitab we are using, spreadsheet data basis packages. Nowadays our software with us, so we can use this software also. Now writing up, remove unnecessary qualifying or repetitive words in your sentence. Just you read, you don't use any type of jargons in your writing whenever you writing your research paper. You can use the simple and short sentences, don't use any perhaps clauses, and again and again repeat a same word. It is actually vague of your, it seems like a vague of your data, so you just remove all these things. Matlab aapko aise words use nahi karne hain jo kahin na kahin contradictory ho aur it is not related with your topic, to aap koshish kare unko chhodne ki. Now the summarize one or more sentences, perhaps whole para in one sentence, try to in a small sentence and connect with the other sentences also. Ye dhyan rakhna hai for one para, after that you will write the other para, so it will be connected with your first para, and actually research paper is just like a story writing. तो ये देखना है कि हमारी कनेक्टिविटी ना उस पैरा से हो रही हो, क्योंकि रीडर्स को इंटरेस्ट आना बहुत जरूरी है. डिलीट रेफरेंसेस कोटेशंस विच आर नॉट एसेंशियल इन योर डिस्कशन या फॉर योर डिस्कशन या इन योर रिसर्च पेपर, तो प्लीज डिलीट दिस टाइप ऑफ रेफरेंसेस एंड कोटेशंस. रिप्लेस लेंथ डिस्क्रिप्शन बाय टेबल्स और चार्ट वेयर पॉसिबल. एक्चुअली व्हेन वी विल इनकॉर्पोरेट दी सम चार्ट्स or some graphs or some tables in our research paper, so it looks very nice and easily understood to any person. Koi bhi banda us par easily work kar sakta, easily kaam kar sakta, to wo kafi useful rehta hai. Now write up flow. First of all abstract, actually abstract in the last when we have done the our work all over the work regarding the research paper, then we will write the abstract at the end of the research paper. First the introduction, so in a whole research paper 10% of words or space for the introduction part. Review of literature related with your topic, it's a 20% space in your research paper. Then you will design your methodology and research work which you have mentioned as a research design in your question paper, it's a 10%. Or what is the implementation of your research work, yeah, the way of presenting of your data, it's a 15 to 20%. comment and critics on the outcomes and findings. This is the most important part of your research paper. Any reader, read always this part, 20%. So it is most important, and it is very well articulated in your research paper. And after that, summary and conclusion regarding your research paper, and then reference and bibliography and appendix, all things are required. So first, when we will write our research paper, first is the introductory part. It's in a one para or one and a half pages more maximum limit. So you just in the introductory part, just to explain about the present work regarding your present jo bhi world mein ho raha hai at present, wo aap us research paper ke introductory part mein do. After that, review of literature. Review of literature, we have already find out literature. And review of, so then you just pick up the 5 or 10 which is more related to your research work, wo aap review uske andar mention karein. After that, your research objective, okay, why you are writing this research paper. So one or two ya three objectives are sufficient in one research paper. And after that, research methodology. Research methodology yani research design, किस तरीके से, मतलब रोड मैप ऑफ योर रिसर्च पेपर, जस्ट लाइक व्हाट इज योर एरिया ऑफ रिसर्च एंड व्हाट इज द सोर्सेज, व्हिच टाइप ऑफ टेस्ट यू हैव यूज्ड इन योर रिसर्च पेपर, एंड व्हाट इज द मेथड यू आर यूजिंग डेटा कलेक्शन फॉर डेटा कलेक्शन, एंड योर व्हाट इज योर सैंपल साइज, दीज आर द रिसर्च डिजाइन. आफ्टर दैट, एनालाइजिंग द डेटा. Analyzing in the way of the just we have already discussed the questionnaire. If we have done the questionnaire, yeah, already we have making the, matlab humne bana liya. After that, we have analyzed, and we will analyze through the descriptive analysis, yeah, descriptive method. Then the presentation and analyzing your data. After that, articulation in your the interpretation. It is the most important part when you articulate your research paper. So articulate in a very well, which is defined your table, which is explain your table, whenever you explain about your tables and everything. And last, what is the conclusion? You have you have already prepared the all things. So what is the conclusion of your research paper? And also in the last, mention the future scope also. Yeah, or limitation or your research. Actually, for a safer side, it is very necessary to give the limitation in your research paper, क्योंकि ये जरूरी नहीं है कि आप सारे areas को आप cover कर लें, या time limit sufficient है उसके लिए, ये कोई जरूरी नहीं है. तो these are the limitations of your research work. And future scope, yeah, definitely in every research paper there is a some future scope also. तो आप उसको identify करें in a future scope way. And after that, the referencing and everything. Referencing, in a last I'll explain. Now the grammar, try and avoid long sentence. I have already discussed, avoid one sentence paragraph, avoid matlab just like in a one sentence you have write down the whole paragraph. Avoid beginning sentences with joining words such as but and because, please avoiding this type of word in a starting the paragraph or sentence. Avoid incorporating a lengthy list of material in your text. If you need any list, to please specified and comprehend list you have mentioned. Understand and make use of the full range of standard punctuations form, including in particular the column, semicolon, comma and full stop. And now the referencing, it's a most important part of our research paper. Actually, when we have read the some article, we will review the some articles. We have reviewed some article research paper. We have already mentioned in our research paper. So then the referencing also mentioned in the last of the paper. First, the author name, year, and title of the research paper, where it is published, and the page number. If it is possible, so it is also mentioned in the referencing. So, and after that, bibliography. Actually, there is a very big difference between the reference and bibliography. Actually, reference, just we have referred in our research paper for the किसी भी particular author की, मैंने अगर कोई particular theory या particular things we have already referred in our research paper, so it comes in the referencing. And when for the bibliography, जस्ट बस आई गो थ्रू द रिसर्च आर्टिकल या मैगजीन फॉर गेनिंग द नॉलेज अबाउट आर माई टॉपिक. सो वी विल जस्ट लाइक अ बुक नेम या जनरल या एनी आर्टिकल यू जस्ट रेड और फॉर द नॉलेज वो इट कम्स इन द बिब्लियोग्राफी. नाउ द वेबियोलोग्राफी इट्स अ न्यू व्हेन वी आर सर्विंग सम वेबसाइट्स तो वेबियोलॉजी वी विल गिव द ऑल इन पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट इंफॉर्मेशन इन द वेबियोग्राफी. वेबियोग्राफी इट इज रिलेटेड विद द वेबसाइट्स वी हैव कलेक्ट द डेटा इफ एनी टाइप ऑफ वेबसाइट्स. Now plagiarism, now the many online resources are available for plagiarism checkers. It's a most commonly used. So, and every university have their own software, plagiarism software. So we can check the plagiarism through this software. And if there is in plagiarism, just like aapne kuch sentence as it is likhi hai, so please edit this and remove from your paper. And again, अपने पेपर से आप रिमूव करके देन यू विल क्लियर फ्रॉम द प्लैगरिज्म एस्पेक्ट. क्योंकि प्लैगरिज्म आजकल सारी जितने भी जर्नल्स हैं वो डेफिनेटली उसका चेक करते हैं. तो प्लीज अवॉइड द प्लैगरिज्म मैक्सिमम. स्टैंडर्ड वे कहूँ तो 10-15% इन अ वन रिसर्च पेपर इट इज परमिशेबल. एंड इफ योर कंसेप्ट इज टोटली न्यू तो आई थिंक वहां पर आएगा ही नहीं प्लैगरिज्म. So now it's from my side. Thank you to all of you listening patiently, and thank you to I am also very much thankful to our entire team of Parul University for organizing this type of lecture. Thank you so much. Hello.
Thank you, Deepti ma'am. It was yes, ma'am. I hope I'm audible.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. I mean, you have somehow managed to share A to Z of the research. I mean, covering this in 1 hour itself was a big challenge, and beautifully lived up to the expectation.
Exactly.
Yes, I understand. Amita madam, what do you have to say on this?
I completely agree that covering up such a vast topic in just one hour, and that too I think the way she has handled is quite appreciable, because she has thrown each and every light on each and every aspect, and also done justice with each and every aspect of it. That is what I felt.
Yes, exactly, yeah. Ma'am, and my hats off to you, Deepti ma'am. I think we are getting some good comments from the participants from Google Meet, and hopefully the viewers on the Facebook also must have felt the same. And right from the explanation of this term research coming down to plagiarism, you know, so it had been a wonderful session, ma'am. And yes, ma'am. We have short of time. We have to wrap up the session. Otherwise, I think students would have loved to ask so many questions. Even I had questions to ask. Maybe next time in future.
No, definitely, ma'am. Can I add one sentence also? Actually, ma'am, it's a very narrow. I know very well कि बहुत ही मुश्किल है. It is very typical. In a 1 hour, if we say about the how to write a research paper, but we I think I try मतलब I was trying to just कि एक line मिल पाए कि in which way we will write the research paper. And after that, if there is any query, so please mail me and give me my number also to students. If there is any type of query regarding the any type of method. Definitely, I'll try to my best on my end कि मैं उनको satisfy questions दे पाऊँ. It's a wonderful thing for me also. Thank you so much to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I'll definitely, if any of the viewers or participants in Google Meet, if you have some questions or you have something to ask with Deepti ma'am, you can always take her contact details from me. And you're most welcome, as ma'am had already given the permission, to drop a mail or any query if in case you have related with research. Without taking much of time, on behalf of Parul University, ma'am, and Faculty of Management Studies, I want to thank you for gathering so much of information and sharing that piece of information in 1 hour. And thanks to you, Amita ma'am, for referring her for this session and being here for this session also throughout the session. Thank you. And thank you all the participants. Hopefully in the coming week, again, we are going to come up with a very interesting webinar. So stay tuned and have a nice day. Stay safe. And thank you so much, Deepthi ma'am. And thank you, Amita ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Shall I leave?
Yeah, ma'am, you can leave. Thank you. Thank you so much.